A mystery illness has plagued young girls in Colombia, and authorities there are saying that the Gardasil vaccine is to blame. Now, first, the girls describe first their hands and feet feel cold, then they go pale and cannot move. Some convulse and fall to the floor. Dozens of teenagers have experienced similar symptoms. Some have even lost consciousness. A 15-year-old reports that they vaccinated her in May. She started fainting in August. She said, "My legs became heavy and I couldn't feel my hands anymore. When I woke up, I was in the hospital." Now, according to hospital officials, about 370 minors have checked into the facility, and there was also one boy among them. Now, U.S. drug giant Merck, which makes the Gardasil vaccine, said it was confident in the safety profile of its product, but they assure you that they're going to continue following this situation closely. That's what they always say. They're going to continue to follow this situation. How many women have to fall ill or become paralyzed or infertile or die until Merck and other drug makers will be held accountable and they will take this HPV vaccine off the market? When is the balance there? How many girls have to die to see that this is not, it's causing more ill than it's actually helping? Now, we have reported how a vaccination campaign has been used in places like Colombia and elsewhere to curb population growth and thereby making a lot of the women infertile. But in the latest scheme that's designed to implement a world government, the banksters are now aligning themselves behind the climate change agenda. So this is their new thing. This is a cartel of globalist banks, and they produced a report on the need for economic collaboration to help nations adapt and avert the impact of climate change. Now, this report calls for Agenda 21-style sustainable development policies to combat disputed anthropogenic climate change. This includes dense cities. Now, carbonists argue that dense cities are designed for efficiency and they offer one of the most promising paths to sustainability. Other promising paths include control of water allocation and distribution, outlawing private transportation in favor of eco-conscious transportation modes or not allowing you to drive, and restricting individual use of nature to protect biodiversity. So in short, smart growth and biodiversity are about eliminating private property and the rights of the individual, and sustainability is more about the sustaining of the global elite and creating an authoritarian globalist apparatchik to control the lives of billions of people. Now, I really recommend that you go to the Alex Jones channel there on YouTube and watch the extended report by Alex Jones. It's called Agenda 21 Equals Death. Educate yourself, watch and share that report. It is up on our YouTube channel. Now, Natural Society is reporting that GMO grass is coming to the market. Now, this is a huge threat to those who rely on grass-fed beef as a source of healthy, properly raised meats. You can always avoid animals that are fed on GM grain. Well, now cattle is going to be forced to indulge in genetically modified grass. The Scotts Miracle-Gro Company has announced that they're going to conduct field trials at the homes of Scotts employees. Now, what's more, they can do so without any government oversight because there are no laws that prohibit or limit the planting of GMO grass. Scotts is Monsanto's exclusive agent for the marketing and distribution of consumer Roundup. Of course they are. So they're really going to sell this on, ooh, you're going to have beautiful green grass, and never point out the dangers of the fact that cattle are going to be fed this genetically modified version of grass. Now, there is a petition linked within that article. It is up at Infowars.com. But there, that petition will take you to companies to ask them to boycott this GM grass, as well as you can request for your grocery store to only carry certified GMO-free grass-fed beef. So is anyone else totally sick and tired of biotech giants trying to infiltrate every single agricultural market on the planet?
celebrate the spirit of freedom and liberty upon which our nation was founded at InfoWarsShop.com. Molon Lave is ancient Greek for come and take it. This popular design combines both classic Greek Spartan imagery with modern M16 assault rifles. Now available in women's tees and proudly made in the USA. Celebrate the spirit of 1776 with the George Washington brass belt buckle or this incredibly sharp-looking 1776 hat. Badass. And be sure to check out the new arrivals at InfoWars Life, where you can prepare your body to perform at peak levels with Survival Shield Nascent Iodine, Super Male Vitality, and Fluoride Shield. And wake up, America. Immune Support Blend is the healthy choice for the gourmet coffee lover. So get incredibly high-quality, freedom-based products and help fund the revolution at InfoWarsShop.com.